This is my favorite movie of 2019. So far. Yeah, fuck it. This is my favorite movie so far of 2019. Ladies and gentlemen, Knives Out. God damn, this movie was so good, man. It's just so good. An all-star cast gets together again for a fantastic murder mystery film. I'm gonna say this right now. Please go out and check out this film if you're interested in it whatsoever. Obviously, if you're a fan of murder mysteries, because this is gonna be that type of film where it's gonna really be our efforts as film fans and the community to make this movie strive. The trials and tribulation of the financially fit Thrombey family, the head of the household, the grandfather, played by Christopher Plummer, Harlan Thrombey, was the main asset in this entire film. And after one mysterious night, he is then found dead, a possibly committed suicide, and this, when this story takes place, that's when it sets off, and that's where it starts to glide. It has that traditional feel of a whodunit, but Rian Johnson just spins it on his head and turns the whodunit into another whodunit with a twist to it, things that I personally didn't see coming, and that took me for a spin the entire time. I wouldn't say per se this is a slow burn type of film. To me, it felt like it definitely had a snowball effect though. It started pacing itself really consistent at the beginning of the film, and then halfway through, it just starts rolling and rolling, and it gets pretty intense towards the second half of the film. This film leaves you clues at little nooks and crannies. It's essentially in a clue house, and they actually joke at it in the movie, but it's the perfect scenery for an awesome murder mystery with an excellent twist. Rian Johnson, after working on Star Wars The Last Jedi, a film that he received a lot of flack for, even though in my opinion the cinematography was fantastic, was amazing. I did as well as you guys, that a lot of people that saw the film definitely had questions of the story and the pacing of how Last Jedi went. But man, he has a phenomenal record doing movies like Looper. So this one, definitely, he knocked it straight out of the ballpark. This film has an emotional attachment to me just because murder mysteries are films that I definitely love. I feel like we don't get enough of them nowadays. They're really, the last one that came out was Murder at the Orient Express, and that was actually a remake. So it's amazing to get an original classic look at the traditional murder mystery. In the start of the film, it starts off that traditional pacing where you think it's just a classic whodunit. You find the character that possibly committed suicide. The detective is there, and the detective's in a house full of people trying to figure out who is the murderer. And then it takes it for a complete spin. Innocent characters making silly mistakes to try to cover up the acts of their crime. Daniel Craig playing Detective Blanc. I can tell you right now, when it first started, he has a much different accent than you've ever seen him do before. Nothing like Bond or anything else. It's a very thick southern accent. At the start of the film, it kind of felt a little shaky to me because it just felt a little bit different on him. But as the movie progressed, it soothed right in, it marinated right in, and you could believe the voice coming from Daniel Craig. This is like a sick Scooby-Doo mystery turned on its head and thrown up 1,000 feet in the air and then splattered on the ground. It's just insane how Rian Johnson put this together. Check this film out. It gives my recommendation. If you're interested in this film at all, definitely give it a look. There's been some heavy hitters so far in 2019. In my opinion, this was the best movie I've seen so far. We've got about a month and a half left, so we're gonna see if any other film could beat this in my personal top five. This is holding the number one spot, and it might be a little hard to beat. Throwing it to you guys, let me know down in the comments below what you thought of Knives Out and if it cracks your top five or top 10 for 2019. Close to our 1K milestone, so please, if you haven't yet, please subscribe to the channel. Come on in, we're trying to get to that first goal, and I would appreciate if you guys would join us. More videos here, subscribe down here, and I'll see you in the next video. Be easy.